welcome every one of you to one more episode of Women on Fire. What a wonderful thing that God Himself should call us women on fire. That doesn't mean the men cannot be on fire. It only means that the army of God cannot be completed when there is only the men. God is enlisting women to join in to be a mighty warrior bride for the last days. So, welcome, Women on Fire. We are talking once again about the bride. We discussed about the betrothal stage.
Yes.
The courtship, which is the second stage. And now, time has passed. The bride has made herself ready. And marriage time.
Amen.
Consummation time. Now, we know in the world what a consummation of a marriage is it not?
Yes.
Well, some of us had a very good idea. Some of us are still wondering. Mm-hmm. You know, all these virgins are still wondering. Your turn will come. And the consummation of the marriage with the Lord is coming. But what does it really mean in the spirit for a spiritual bride of the believers to have a consummation?
Is it like Mary when she gave what was precious to her, the alabaster box? She broke the alabaster box, and she just gave what is precious to her. So that's
right.
The consummation, that we give everything that's precious.
Absolutely. Oh, thank you, Amusa. That's right. This alabaster box was filled with fragrant oil.
Mm-hmm.
It was worth a lot of money. And this is, in those days, there was like a dowry.
That's right.
It was like the all the worth of this bride to a bridegroom.
Mm-hmm.
In those days, that's how it was.
Yes.
So what she did, she forsook what it meant to be a dowry, to be what all the wealth that she could give to an earthly bridegroom. And she put it at the feet of the Lord. So she forsook.
So it shows that she's willing to separate herself from the world.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Even the importance that it was at that time for a handmaiden to find a husband that will take care of her. But for that, in those days, the woman or the parents had to give some worth. In some countries, this is still going. In some countries, you know, the parents or the bride has to bring to the bridegroom or the family of the bridegroom some jewelry or whatever that it is. I'm not very familiar with it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's how it was then. And this girl broke everything she had, everything that represented her worth.
That's right. She emptied herself.
Emptied herself. Thank you, Norma. That's wonderful.
Everything she said. Oh,
that's right.
That's it. It's all I have.
That's right.
It's for you.
Yeah. Amen. She gave it all to anoint his feet. To anoint his head.
I'm all yours.
And I tell you, for her to wash his feet with her tears, that must have been the tears of I'm forsaking all.
Everything.
You know, the other thing that just came to me, when she broke the alabaster box,
yes,
that breaking itself is telling, she's breaking everything that holds her back to the earth.
Amen. Oh, hallelujah. What a wonderful revelation that is.
That's right.
She broke, cut off.
Consume it also, broke.
That's right. That's right. And so we see that to get to that stage, we are made ready and prepared by God. We make ourselves ready, but God is helping us in the readiness through the Word, through revelation, through His love.
Mm.
Is it not? We've gone through the process of betrayal, to the surrender of fear, to the surrender of everything. Then He knows she is the one. The chosen one. That's when He finally, the betrothal ring that He gave, that's where it becomes totally hers. And that's when the consummation of the union, the marriage, when He takes her with Himself
as His own.
As His own.
And it also is the perfection of love that she has attained.
Amen. Amen. She has attained, thank you, Lord, the perfection of love.
That cast away all fear.
All fear. Yes.
That's right.
The perfection of love that cast away all fear. What a wonderful thing. And you know what? It wouldn't be there if it's not possible.
That's right.
It is well possible. And the Lord sent the Holy Spirit to help us along the way.
Yes.
To anoint
That's right.
us.
That's right.
Now we know in the earthly realm, a lady and a man get married, and there's a consummation of marriage, where both become
one.
Mm-hmm. Right? We don't have time to talk about that, but it's shedding of blood
mm-hmm.
in this consummation.
It's a covenant, no?
It's a covenant, mm-hmm. yes.
Mm-hmm.
So in the things of God, He shed His blood for her to be able to marry her. And she comes and shares her life. Life is in the blood.
That's right, yes.
So by sharing her life, she's shedding her blood, every drop of her being.
And when you say the covenant, that's a symbolic act because His blood is mingled with her blood.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's right.
So that the covenant of blood, and that covenant of blood makes them one.
Yes.
Said in June 17,
that's right.
The prayer of the Lord, that we may be one. And when that takes place, when He takes all of her, and she takes all of Him, she no longer says, "My beloved is mine, and I am His." She no longer says, "I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine." This is what she says. Song of Songs, chapter 7, verse 10.
She says, "I am my beloved, and His desire is towards me."
So, she has come to the realization, she no longer boasts that He is hers. She no longer boasts that she is His. If there ever be any boasting, is that He delights in me.
Amen.
He can tell all the maids, the handmaids, the whole entire world, He delights in me. What a wonderful, it's a revelation. You know, if your spouse has delighted in you, when you become intimate. How else will you know?
Actually, it's such a beautiful love relationship because the whole process, He was loving her into loving Him.
Yes!
Isn't
hallelujah!
Yes.
Hallelujah! So it is wonderful and it's so real. And I believe that there are so many people that want to experience that love. And they are wondering, is that for real?
Mm-hmm.
I hear this person say this, I hear this brother say that sister say that. What about me? Don't be discouraged.
Mm-hmm.
It's a stage.
Yes.
So what we need to ask ourselves, what stage I'm at. Am I still wondering whether is there anything that I am holding back? Have I surrendered everything? Have I come to let go of my fears and my concerns and the loss of friends and the loss of family members and the loss of whatever I've been used to do? Am I in the second stage? Or have I already come? If you have come to the marriage consummation, you know that you know that you know. Why? Because you no longer have fears.
Yes. Yes,
no more fears. Mm. You're no longer needy.
They are one now.
Yes.
His thoughts become her thoughts.
Yes.
That's right. Mm. And you're no longer longing for love. Mm. Love is all over you. That's why you can say he delights in me. It's all over
That's
you.
Right.
I'm not needy anymore. I'm super abundant. Come,
That's
let
right.
me give you some of his love.
And 1 John 4:8 says, God is love.
Love. Amen.
And if we are securing this love, we are full of him.
Amen.
We are securing him. And this is, I believe, many people needed
yes.
to be securing this love.
Love.
Because when we are securing this love, we are free.
Amen.
To be accepted
Amen.
The way we
Amen.
Are.
Amen.
And we accept what he wants to do in our lives.
Yes. Oh,
this
hallelujah.
Love is set us free.
That's right.
And I believe we need more and more of this love. And I believe many people need to know this treasure that set us free.
Yes. Amen. No matter what stage we are, his love is real.
Amen.
Yeah.
His love is so real.
And he's ever faithful.
He's ever faithful. Yeah. Well, if you have been encountered by unfaithfulness in your life.
That's right.
He's faithful.
Yes.
He's faithful. If your marriage has been broken, if your heart has been broken, there's one that will never break your heart.
Amen.
That's Jesus.
That's Jesus.
Amen.
And love never fails.
Love never fails. Never fails. What a wonderful chapter.
That's right.
Please. At our own private time, let's meditate on chapter 13 of the book of Corinthians, first book of Corinthians. It's just so amazing. So going on with this, we realize that the world is now meaningless.
Yes.
It doesn't matter. It's meaningless. It has no longer any meaning. And I have seen people, I have seen ladies transformed by this love in the process. They would like this and they would like nothing wrong with that. God loves to shower us with blessings and with things, you know, and beautify us.
Right.
But they come to the stage where you don't look for that.
For that at all.
Yes.
You don't forsake it, but you don't look for it. If God gives you perfect, if not perfect, you know, it just doesn't matter. We are not longer held by the material things, by jewelry, by clothing. I mean, what lady doesn't like to have nice clothes and look good for the bridegroom, right? But the thing is, those things are not possessing us.
That's right.
No longer possessing us. He possesses us.
Amen.
And he's the source of everything. It's just so wonderful. Another thing is, we are no longer fearful or needy because we also share his
love
and his authority.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah.
We are now with him. In our submission to him, his power and authority is all over us. And we can move in that power. Now, we are no longer hungry for love.
Yes, we already have it.
We have love.
And we are sharing now.
Now we share, absolutely,
yes.
we share love.
And we have become love.
And we have become love.
Yes.
That's right, because we are one with love. I haven't thought of that. Praise the Lord, thank you. We have become love. And when we become love, anybody can touch love.
Yes.
Everybody can have part of you. And we can be that vessel where people come and eat and drink of the Lord through us.
Mm.
by the Spirit of God. Yeah. We no longer pursue happiness.
Yes.
Because happiness depends on something happening from the outside to make me feel happiness in the inside. We have joy in the inside. And nothing that happens outside takes away that joy. Nothing.
Nothing.
No circumstances on the outside, because we don't depend anymore in the outside things, what this looks like, what this person doing or not doing, whether the things are the way we want them or not want them. Doesn't matter. We have this joy. There is a joy, 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 joy in my heart. It's just bubbling.
And also because the bridegroom, he fulfills the bride in every aspect.
Absolutely.
There's nothing that she needs.
That's right. Now, I'd like us to look into the warrior bride. How, through this marriage consummation, then God's plan is to make that bride a warrior bride. Why warrior? Why warrior? Why battle? We just gone through love. Why fight? Yes.
Because he is the captain, not host, who is coming.
Absolutely.
Yes.
He's a warrior king.
Yes, who is coming.
All right. He's
coming to this world and looking for his bride. So if he's a warrior king, then we are warrior bride.
We are absolutely. Absolutely. That's warrior. And what is he coming to have war against in these last days?
The enemy.
Enemies.
Satan and all.
Principalities and powers.
That's
and
right. Darkness. He has already defeated the enemy.
Yes.
He has made a public display, the Word of God says, of him as a defeated enemy. He's a defeated force, is the Word of God. He's already defeated, but he's coming to claim his victory.
Yes.
He's coming to put him away, and all those that follow him put away. So this earth is no longer covered by great darkness, neither the people by gross darkness.
Yes.
That will be removed. This will be like another world, a new world. Why? Because he's coming to do away with all that that has caused so much damage to this world.
Yes.
His precious creation being so damaged that even creation is groaning for the rising of the sons of God, this warrior bride, to rise up and begin to move in the anointing and the power of the Holy Spirit, speaking unto being, which is not, bringing creation back to the inheritance of eternity. What a wonderful, amazing, I can imagine what it'll be all like.
Wow. It is the last day's army that God is raising.
The last day's army.
And in saying that also, I can see also now and appreciate why the bride has to be made ready and be perfect and not blemished, you know. Because if she's not perfect, she cannot go to war with him.
That's right.
She cannot participate in that war that he is entering.
That's right. Well, beloved, we come to the end. But before we close, we want to put a scripture before that is in Song of Solomon, chapter 6, verse 16. To make the story very short, is the Lord is with his army, with his friends. They're not battling, they are together. Now, the Shulamite is looking for fruits. The Shulamite is the bride, looking for fruits. The fruits are of the Spirit. So he's looking, she's looking. Suddenly the Spirit takes her, like in a chariot. She finds herself and she sees peeping at her bridegroom with all the other soldiers. So she gets a little bit, she's in the wrong place. But they see her And he calls her, he says, return, return, oh Shulamai, that we may behold you. What does it mean? She has been taken in the spirit. She has entered into the realm of her bridegroom. She's not sure whether she's in the right place or not. But he says, come, return, don't go away. This is where you belong now. You're my bride. You belong in the spirit. You no longer move in the earthly realm. No more the flesh. Now we are one. Now we are victorious. Come. And she's still uncertain and she says, why should you want to behold the Shulamite? As if in the dance of Mahanaim. And Mahanaim means in Hebrew, the two camps. The camp of the heavenly realm and the camp of the earthly realm. So she, the bride, becomes one with the heavenly realm. And together, win the battle.
Amen.
Where would you like to be? My dear beloved, God, I know, wants you to be in that warrior army. Make yourself ready. I feel that the Lord is talking to many of you. There's some people that are crying. Just let the anointing of the Lord come upon you right now.
Thank you, Lord.
Receive it. I sense even in my heart, some hearts are opening like a blossom. Let that fire come. Let that love fill every part of your being. Some people are, well, this breathing that you experience is the breath of God coming inside of you, breathing and filling every part. The Spirit of God is filling every part of you, changing, transforming areas in your life that will not surrender. Breathing, let Him. Breathing the Holy Spirit. Breathe out the old self. Shall we pray?
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, Father, we thank you so much as you've taken us to the understanding,
yes, Lord,
to the consummation of the marriage, what it means to be made ready as a bride,
yes, Lord,
and what is the concept of a warrior bride,
yes, Lord,
a bride that moves in your spirit. I pray, Lord, that everyone that is listening to this program, Lord, that is now talking to you, now crying out to you, now repenting about the things that they've been holding back, repenting of their fears, Lord. Let the very words that you've spoken through your vessels, Lord, wash away every filthiness, every darkness from the wonderful garment of this bride. I see a precious garment being made ready, almost coming down from heaven to fit each and every one of you who are saying, yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And there is an altar that I see, an altar where the old self is placed. And I see some of you are actually picking your own self in the spirit, like picking your own body in the spirit and laying it down in that altar. Thank you, Father. As your people are by faith doing this, Lord, receive the sacrifice.
Yes, Lord.
Receive it, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And give the grace and the power that you have preserved for your people to walk with God like Enoch did, to be the warrior bride that brings peace upon this earth by joining you in the final victory battle. Blessed are the peacemakers, your word says, to bring peace. Lord, anoint your people.
Thank you, Lord.
To go through this battle with you, Lord. To lay down everything that they may possess everything. Mm-hmm. I see some people have been fitted with this dress. I see there is a lady that never thought, because of the kind of life you lived, looking for love in the streets and looking for true love in places where you could not really find it. Finally, you have discovered love. You have discovered him. And he's got this garment ready for you. And I see this dress fitting you. And in some ways you say, Lord, it's a bit tight here, it's a bit tight there. You're uncomfortable a little bit with not knowing yourself as such. But the Lord is saying to you, lose your identity and take my name, and it will fit you perfect. And I see you saying, yes, Lord. The moment you're saying, yes, Lord, I see you like losing weight. Amazing. Like you are losing weight from your arms and your bosom and fitting perfect into the new garment, the new self. Thank you, Father. Father, I pray you bless each and every one of your people and everyone that has been listening to this program, that your word, which has gone forth by the power of your Spirit, will not return to you void.
Thank you, Lord.
But will accomplish everything you have desired. For it is you alone, by the power of your Spirit, that knows our heart and accomplishes the work of your word in us, Lord. So now, Lord, be glorified across the whole world.
Thank you, Lord.
Through your people consecration. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Precious beloved, the time has come. But until next week, may the Lord bless you.